Okay, so this is another take. We're going to call this take three. I'm going to try to do this within 10 minutes, okay? So 10 minutes starts now. I did this already, but I didn't have the things in the camera view. I need to make sure that it gets into the camera. All right, so let me talk about the elements this time first. You need a dumb clapper or you need a digital slate, either a digital slate or a dumb slate. You need transmitters for time code, and you need receivers. And you also need that time code generator. In my case, the transmitters and the receivers are the same unit. What the transmitters do, they keep time of day. Whatever the military time of day it is, that is what it's going to keep for you, is the military time. And you need to know the frame rate. If you don't have the frame rate connected to the camera and you don't have the frame rate connected to the slate, and with the audio editing software or the video editing software for that matter, then it will not be in sync. Cables and ports. All you need to know is BNC and quarter inch ports. That is the only ports that you're really using to make sync work, is the BNC ports and the quarter inch ports. You need batteries, and this all deals with audio peaks, and we call it an audio spike if you don't use the time code. So you can look at the audio spike as a backup just in case the audio time code, excuse me, just in case the slate doesn't work, you have the clapper as a backup. And then the camera mic. So everything that I just mentioned is what is needed to make time code work for what we need. All right, so this particular generator, I need to make sure that you can see it in view. This particular time code generator or time code receiver has been already on. So the slate is already showing you that it's set at 7:50 p.m. and 28 seconds, okay? So that's what that's basically saying. It's saying 7:50 and 35 seconds. When you put it in front of the camera, when you put this in front of the camera, when you clap it, you'll say, let's say, on parole, scene one, take two, and action. Then it is zero out. And then the camera will catch that. And when they go edit, they can line up the audio spike and they can line up the zeros with the video, right? So that's how it becomes in sync. And the audio signal is being placed inside the camera. Now, if it's a camera that has a BNC time code, then the time code is being burnt in the audio and the video. It's being burnt inside the file. That's what you want. But in the case of DSLRs, that's what I have. I use these type because it's based off of audio, or what they call linear time code. It's just an audio signal, okay? So the BNC converter converts it into digital time code, but this is linear time code. So you have the clapper with the transmitter, then you have the camera with the transmitter. So the other thing that is involved is having your audio device with the a time code, either using one of the audio inputs, right? Or I bought this one on purpose because it has a time code BNC connector. It has that port already built into this one. So what I said in the last video, but I have to repeat, this is not a professional recording, field recorder. It can record, but it only has two channels. And if you can see, it doesn't have a combo. So you can't even put a quarter inch on these, just XLRs. And this input for line, doesn't mean anything. So if you put the time code there, I don't even know what would really happen to the code, right? So what you would do, you can feed the time code in one of these XLRs, but now you need a converter to do that. You need a quarter inch to XLR converter. And now you only have one channel for your dialogue, for your boom. You know, so that's why this type is not used on a professional set. It doesn't have enough channels. It doesn't have enough features, okay? So to recap, your audio device would have time code being burnt in to the actual audio, not on a channel, but burnt in, which is way different than it being on a channel. Then you have your clapper with the same time, and that time needs to be updated throughout the day. It may not be even necessary to update it, but if you're doing a long shoot, you don't want it to ever fall out of a frame. So you basically just resync the devices using your app. So these particular transmitters work off of a phone app, and I just resync them because the time of day won't change, okay? So the time of day is just gonna keep going. So right now it's 7:54 and 36 seconds. So if I clap it, it's gonna zero out. And that zero means that it should be in line with the audio spike, right, with the clap. And that's how they do sync. The camera has to have the audio input either using the BNC burnt in time code, the digital time code, or it needs linear time code, which is audio. I know some of this might be confusing, but at the end of the day, it matters which camera you use, because every camera is going to have its own way of doing time code. So either if it's a DSLR, it may not have a BNC. So you have to use the linear time code, the audio time code. But if it's a higher pro camera, a cinema camera, most likely it's going to have a BNC port for time code. So one of the other things I talked about in the last take was my boom. I don't know if you can see my boom. I extended it this time and it goes pretty far. No one has to touch it. It's very sturdy. And that's another way that I was able to get away with using the boom pole, is because if you're not moving, then you could just put the boom pole and it'd go above the whole crew and won't get in the way. But you got to have a professional grade. This is basically a mic stand, right? But it's for a boom pole. And then you need to have sandbags. Like I have sandbags. You might not even be able to see it, but I have sandbags. So that way it doesn't get rocked on the set. But anyway, so what I've covered on this video is talking about the clapper, either using a dumb slate or a digital slate. If you use the dumb slate, then you don't have to worry about time code. Once the video has this audio microphone, and once your audio is on record, once you do that, your audio on your camera and the audio on your recorder will see that spike. And that's how you line up the audio with the video. That's an old trick. If you're not using time code, you can basically eyeball it, but you can only go so far with eyeballing. It takes more time, so it's time consuming to do many clips. What if you did four takes on every shot? Every shot took four takes. You multiply that by how many scenes you have. You multiply that by how many pickup shots you have. You multiply that by how many reverse shots that you have. You multiply that by how many, you know, close-ups you have. Then it could be pretty much a lot of work, okay? All right, then I talked about the transmitters. And in this case, I'm using Tentacle Sync. And the Tentacle Sync basically is a 2-in-1. It transmits and it also receives. So once Once you sync it in the app, all of the devices will be in sync with each other. So if you have five devices, all five will be in sync together. Time of day is dealing off is going off a military time of day, which comes from the actual devices themselves, which comes from the actual app. You could change that and configure it and make it display something else if you wanted to. I talked about frame rate. Without the frame rate being consistent throughout all the devices and the software, you might as well not even do time code if you don't have the frame rate connected, configured in your camera and in your slate and in your editing software. Cables and ports, I've already talked about that. You need batteries to run these. They basically recharge. The ones I have recharge, and that's it. So if you have any questions, let me know. I did that within 10 minutes.